I would like to introduce our second technical session speaker, Mr. Pankaj S. Pariyar sir. He is holding position of director in Skill Maestro. He is MBA in Finance and Information System from New York. He is a recipient of full-time MBA scholarship, having corporate experience of more than 6 years in marketing domain, work with ICCA New York, a KPMG New York Consulting Associate. He has helped thousands of candidates to gain admission to top-ranked B school in the world, many with merit scholarships. Proven track record of increasing candidates' score in GRE, GMAT, SAT. I welcome you, sir, and request you to please enlighten us with your knowledge on the topic. Now, over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Ankush ji. Thank you, Harsh ji. And thank you, Hansraj sir, for giving us such an enlightening session. Thank you, other panel members and participants who are here. So today I'm going to talk about what opportunities we can see beyond India, beyond this geographical location, what career and professional opportunities chartered accountants can go for. So speaking from my personal experience and last 10 years, I've helped a lot of chartered accountants to explore opportunities outside. A lot of students have gone and passed to do their MBAs or masters in finance from different countries, and later on they have landed with good career opportunities over there. So education is just one medium. There are several other mediums which we are going to talk about today through which you can explore these opportunities. And as rightly pointed out by Hansraj sir, because of this global economy and because of this pandemic where remote working has become a necessity, it has opened up a lot of career opportunities for every one of us. We can take up a lot of outsourcing work from there. So traditionally, it's just IT which has dominated our outsourcing industry, right? So within Indore also, you can see there are several IT companies which are taking up work from US, Australia, from other countries. But same thing has come into accounting as well, which is not so prevalent right now in Indore. But slowly and gradually, it is coming up. So we'll be talking about what steps at this point of time you can take in order to start your own accounting outsourcing firm also. What is the connection network that you have to use, from where you can start? So we'll be covering all that within the session. And after that, if you have any questions, you guys can openly ask me about it, right? So I'll begin with my presentation. Just give me a moment. So all of us are mostly aware about CA career opportunities within India, right? We can go to Big Four, we can start our own venture, we can get into taxation, we can get into auditing. So I'm going to touch upon few aspects which usually people are not aware about, or maybe they can explore their career opportunities in those sectors. Just a moment. So I hope you guys are able to see my screen right now, the shared screen.
Yes, it's visible. Yeah, it's visible.
Yeah. So basically, we'll talk about career opportunities for chartered accountants outside India, not only in terms of education, but other career opportunities as well. So let's look at what all options are available. If somebody who is chartered accountant within India, he wants to go outside and explore opportunities. So one very usual option is higher education, right? So in fact, the young chartered accountants who have recently graduated, who have recently completed their professional certification, and have got 2-3 years of experience, 4 years of experience, and do have flexibility of taking up one more degree or higher education, this is one of the good ways to go about it. I'll be discussing in the upcoming slides, subsequent slides, about what kind of options are there in higher education. Then second very lucrative option has come up, which is gaining permanent residency in few countries which are very receptive to Indian chartered accountants. And there are actually a lot of opportunities. If you gain your permanent residency in those countries, you can clear their licenses, you can practice as a chartered accountant within those countries, you can establish your own practice within Australia, Canada, New Zealand. So we'll be talking about that aspect also. And third, the important, very important option, which none of us are considering so far, is starting our own knowledge process outsourcing. As Hansraj sir already pointed it out, that from this year, he's encouraging everybody to have some dollars and pounds which you can start billing from within Indore. Sitting over here, you can charge it from the clients and you can actually make money out of those economies. So which makes total which makes a lot of sense. Reason being, why to keep ourselves restricted to only Indian subcontinent and targeting only Indian clients? Why not to target places where actually payout is more geographically? And you can actually remotely target those clients just by sitting in Indore. You don't have to be physically present in US, Canada, and Australia to target those clients. There are mediums and ways to target those people, which we'll be discussing in our subsequent slides. So let's start with the first thing, which is higher education options. So usually chartered accountants, they have these kind of options. CA वैसे तो इंडिया में अपने आप में ही सबसे बड़ा क्वालिफिकेशन कंसिडर किया जाता है, राइट? स्टिल लॉट ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग देयर सीए, दीज आर द करियर ऑप्शंस दे यूजुअली थिंक अबाउट. सो वन बीइंग एमबीए, मास्टर्स ऑफ बिजनेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, व्हिच दे कैन डू फ्रॉम आउटसाइड कंट्रीज. सो इन पास सेवरल चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स फ्रॉम आवर इंस्टीट्यूट, दे हैव गॉन फॉर एमबीए प्रोग्राम्स इन टॉप रैंकिंग यूनिवर्सिटीज. सो एक मिथ भी है कि क्या हमारी डिग्री या हमारा क्वालिफिकेशन वहाँ के जॉब सिनेरियो में काउंट करेगा, विच एक्चुअली काउंट्स. अ लॉट ऑफ सीए स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव गॉन इन पास्ट, they have given me the feedback that because of their Indian chartered accountancy, that qualification, they were seen in good eyes by their employers and recruiters. Their resumes were shortlisted because employers over there also, they are well aware about this, that how difficult it is to become CA within India. So obviously, one of the qualities which is reflected is that you were diligent with your studies. You have actually covered all those aspects. So you are a hardworking student. That one quality is reflected. Perseverance, diligence, because of which employers are keen on taking you. So as a higher degree option, you can think about getting into MBA, maybe finance, MBA in accounting, and you can work with big fours within Australia, US, Canada, UK, any of these countries where you're going for your MBA programs. Ab wahan pe bhi big four ki presence hai, to aap Deloitte, Ernst & Young, inke paas bhi auditing practitioners, tax practitioners, all of these positions are open over there. It's just that directly sitting from India, if you try to apply for those opportunities, you'll not be entertained. So this is one medium. The education is one medium which will pave a way to those opportunities. Agar aap wahan padhne jaate hain, to aap apne resume pe us country ka education and credibility develop kar rahe hain, and those credentials are going to help you to get into these jobs. So one of the options that you can think about is getting into the MBA programs. A lot of my students who were chartered accountants, they have gone for masters in finance or financial risk management. So I think one of the participants today, CA Riddhi Nagpal, is there, who's attending the session. And she was my student who went for masters in finance in Baruch College, Zicklin School of Business, the City University of New York, from where I have graduated. I did my MBA from there. So Riddhi is currently pursuing her masters in finance program from there, which again is a good value addition in your degree. If you're already a chartered accountant, you're well-versed with the accounting practices, right? Adding up that with a finance degree opens up a lot of opportunities where companies are willing to take you because of your accounting as well as financial knowledge. Then financial risk management positions are also open. Just a moment. Just a moment. I'm disabling the annotation. I think somebody by mistake has, right. So financial risk management again is one of the career options which chartered accountants can look for. This is again a degree program which is being offered in countries like US, UK, Canada, Australia. And you can go for these options. There are multiple opportunities over there. And masters in accounting is again a good field to go for, which chartered accountants might think that why to go for masters in accounting if I already have a CA qualification, right? It is just to give you an entry to a foreign country where maybe your degree is not that recognized or your qualification is not meeting their licensing requirement. So as a value addition, you can take masters in accounting to enter their country, and later on you can take up the recognition of their CPA or whatever their accounting accreditation is. You can later on take that one. Then this is a new field which I think Hemesha ma'am and Hansraj sir were mentioning, that within accounting practices, now analytics and information system have entered, right? So all the companies, see, accountant are not just playing with, they are not just restricted to the bookkeeping part, not just to the bookkeeping aspect, but they are looking beyond that also. With all those balance sheet and numbers, there is huge amount of data that can give you insights and information about the company, where exactly it is going, how it is going to perform. So for all those projections and predictions, a lot of companies, in fact, all the big fours, EY, Deloitte, if you see, they have started recruiting people in the analytics position, the accounting analytics professional. These are the people who know how to play with data along with the accounting knowledge. So there are some IT related tools like SAS, SQL, R programming, which accounting professionals are using in order to generate some good insights from that data. Some companies are using these accounting analytics software to detect fraud within the transaction. Fraud analytics is another extension to this field. Making good decision making using softwares, using the past historical data. That is what the accounting analytics is about. So a lot of young graduates are exploring these options also in US, Canada, Australia. They are going for their master's in accounting information system. This is a good extension because you already know about accounting. If you make yourself technically versed, agar aap IT ke saath apne ko update kar sakte hain, learning few softwares and few database languages, you can actually pave a way for very good career opportunities for yourself, which is accounting analytics. This is currently in huge demand right now. And very few qualified professionals are there. Like if you try to look at US job market, there is actually requirement of around 250,000 professionals within analytics. And utne professionals hain nahi wahan pe abhi. So again, this is opening up a lot of opportunities for you if you're interested in going for accounting analytics coursework. Going to the next slide. What are the best countries when it comes to accounting higher education? Like if you would like to go for accounting related courses, what are the good countries? So depending upon your coursework, countries could be different. Like for example, if I talk about accounting, the good countries to go for accounting is UK, Australia, Ireland, and Canada. Reason being, first of all, our accounting practices are actually very close to what they are following in their countries. Second thing, Indian accountants, they do get good job opportunities within these countries. Their qualification is recognized. You can in fact practice CPA further or their own chartered accountancy. Aap kuch exams clear karke ya kuch further paper clear karke, aap unke yahan pe apna ek designation bhi as a CA, you can practice over there. So these are the countries which we usually recommend if it comes to accounting higher career options. You should be going for UK, Australia, Ireland, and Canada. If it comes to finance education, if you would like to explore finance as an area, then US, Canada, and Ireland, these three are the best countries to go for to make careers within finance. US obviously being the cynosure of the world when it comes to finance, especially the East Coast area, New York, Boston, Philadelphia, if you see these locations, there are plenty of financial opportunities. In fact, Wall Street is the financial capital, which we call. So there are plenty of jobs available over there. So if you're getting into any place near to New York and you're doing your studies over there, it will open up a lot of opportunities for you. So you can probably think about those career options. Let's talk about the second thing, which I was mentioning. If you don't want to go for education and you think that if I get a direct entry to any country, can I look for those options? So that is through permanent residency. Aap apne PR ke through apply kar sakte hain. You can get into any of the countries on your permanent residency. Right. So let's talk about two countries where PR is easy to get. PR abhi sabse easily jo do countries de rahi hain, that is Australia and Canada. Very receptive, very easy to get. You have to qualify their point based system. Both have kept a point qualification. Ab wo dekh lete hain ki wo points kis cheez ke milte hain. If you qualify for those points, you can easily get your PR in these countries. Right? I'll talk about advantages of PR, what exactly you can get through PR. We'll also talk about that. So on what basis PR is given? So it is a point based system, as I suggested, in which you get points for your age, education, qualification, skill set, work experience, and English language proficiency. So all of these would contribute to your permanent residency points. Aapki jitni young age hogi, aapko uske zyada points milte hain in these countries. Reason being, all the countries, they want to attract young talents, young resources within their countries. So provided if you have young age, you might have a leverage, you will get more points for that. Again, when it comes to education, if you have a postgraduate degree along with an undergrad education, you'll be given more points. Just with the undergrad degree, aapke points to rahenge, par PG ke saath aapke points zyada badh jate hain. Then it also comes to your skill set. Skill set is basically, and the good part about your profession being chartered accountant is that the skill set are always in dearth. इनकी हमेशा रिक्वायरमेंट्स हैं इन सब कंट्रीज में. दैट्स व्हाई आप किसी भी कंट्री में जब देखेंगे उनकी शॉर्ट स्किल कैटेगरी लिस्ट होती है, वेदर इट इज ऑस्ट्रेलिया और वेदर इट इज कैनेडा, यू विल सी कि उनके यहाँ पे जो सबसे ज्यादा डिमांड में स्किल सेट होते हैं उसमें यू विल यूजुअली सी इन टॉप 10 स्किल्स अकाउंटिंग ऑलवेज इज मेंशन, राइट. तो आपको इसके स्किल सेट के पॉइंट्स काफी ज्यादा मिल जाते हैं बीइंग इनटू अकाउंटिंग एंड हैविंग दैट काइंड ऑफ वर्क एक्सपीरियंस. आपके स्किल सेट का वैल्यू बहुत ज्यादा है तो उसके भी आपके पॉइंट्स ऐड होते हैं. देन इयर्स ऑफ वर्क एक्सपीरियंस, आपके पास कितने इयर्स का वर्क एक्सपीरियंस है, दैट ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स टू योर पॉइंट्स. एंड देन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज प्रोफिशियंसी विच दे आर जजिंग विद एग्जामिनेशन लाइक IELTS or Pearson Test of English, PT. Two kinds of English tests are there. For Australia, a lot of people, they prefer to give PT, Pearson Test of English. And in case of Canada, for PR process, usually people try to give IELTS examination, which is again an English language proficiency. Why they are checking us on this aspect is because they are inviting you to their country. They want to make sure that your skills and all the qualification that you have along with your language proficiency makes you employable in their country, makes you useful in their country. They don't want people who don't have any kind of skill set, who don't have language proficiency to enter and try to just be done with any kind of jobs. Ki koi bhi jobs pick kare aur usme opportunities explore kare. So that's why they've kept a strict criteria in which skill set is one of the most important aspect. Agar aapke short skills mein aate hain, aapke jo bhi skills hain, to aapke liye points bahut maximum ho jate hain. And this English language proficiency, higher proficiency will fetch you more points. So this is how you qualify for your permanent residency in any of these countries. So the good part being you don't have to pay it to any agents and consultants to do the entire process. Aapka jo PR assessment hai, aap straight away you can go to these websites. For Australia, you can go to their Immigration Home Affairs website. Over there, you can easily calculate how many points you are qualifying for. And whether your profile in terms of education, work experience, dependent, your wife, children, you'll be putting up all that information and you can see how many points are getting accumulated. With that, you can see whether you're qualifying for Australian PR process. You can in fact check same thing for Canadian PR process also. Aap apne points ka assessment khud se hi kar sakte hain. Iske liye you don't have to hire a consultant or agent. You can do it on your own by going to these website links. You can just put your information over there. They'll ask you for a language proficiency score. कि IELTS और PT में आपका स्कोर क्या है. सो यू कैन रेंडमली पुट एनी स्कोर्स. IELTS इज अ 9 बैंड एग्जामिनेशन होता है जिसमें 4 सेक्शंस आते हैं, रीडिंग, लिसनिंग, स्पीकिंग एंड राइटिंग. ईच सेक्शन इज ऑफ 9 बैंड एंड देन क्यूमुलेटिव ऑल्सो द एवरेज स्कोर इज टेकन फ्रॉम 9 ओनली. सो व्हेन दे आर आस्किंग यू फॉर अ रीडिंग, लिसनिंग, स्पीकिंग, राइटिंग स्कोर, यू कैन पुट 777 ऑन ऑल दी सेक्शंस टू सी हाउ मच पॉइंट्स यू आर क्वालिफाइंग फॉर, राइट. So you can do this entire self-assessment to see if your points are qualifying you for a PR process. So let's talk about what exactly is permanent residency. So permanent residency is basically within that country, now you can enter without any restriction, right? But it doesn't mean that PR is not guaranteeing you a job. A lot of people have this misconception that if I qualify for the permanent residency process, that country is going to willingly put me into jobs also, which is not the case. जॉब हंटिंग आपको वैसे ही करनी है जैसे आपने अपने करियर में चालू करी थी, व्हेन यू क्वालिफाइड एज अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट और व्हेन यू वर प्रैक्टिसिंग फॉर योर सीए, व्हेन यू वर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर योर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंसी एग्जामिनेशंस, दैट टाइम यू आर फाइंडिंग आर्टिकलशिप विद इन सम सीए फर्म. सो यू वर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग योर रिज्यूमे, यू वर यूजिंग योर नेटवर्क, राइट. आप अपने फैमिली या अपने फ्रेंड्स में से नेटवर्क को यूज कर करके आर्टिकलशिप फाइंड कर रहे थे. So similarly, once you qualify for PR, the process remains same, just like you were hunting jobs within India. You'll have to go over there, you'll have to network with people, you have to put up your resume on various company websites, you'll have to go for interview process, and this is how you'll qualify for jobs over there. So PR doesn't guarantee you a job, but it opens up multitude of opportunities as it removes any work permit restriction, which is a huge barrier for many immigrants. And moreover, आप अपनी कंपनी भी चालू कर सकते हैं, विच इज द बेस्ट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ गेटिंग योर पीआर. Somebody who is not interested in taking up a job, अगर आप में जॉब में इंटरेस्टेड नहीं है कि मैं किसी कंट्री इमिग्रेट करके अब मैं अपॉर्चुनिटीज या जॉब ढूंढूं, आप बेटर यू कैन इवन थिंक अबाउट ओपनिंग अप योर ओन कंपनी ऑन अ पीआर स्टेटस, विच इज अलाउड इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया, विच इज अलाउड इन कैनेडा. ऑन पीआर स्टेटस यू कैन ओपन अप योर ओन कंसल्टिंग फर्म, योर ओन अकाउंटिंग आउटसोर्सिंग फर्म ऑल्सो यू कैन स्टैब्लिश. I'll come to that point also, जहाँ पे हम process outsourcing की बात कर रहे थे, वहाँ पे आपको ये PR कैसे help कर सकता है, we'll cover that point also. So next is, what do accountants generally get paid in foreign countries? This is the usual pay that I have seen accountants getting in different countries. So US, it is about $70,000 to $95,000. That is US dollar. The Australia dollar, which is written as Australian dollar. It is not US dollar. The dollar symbol is there, but then jo amount likha hai, that is an Australian dollar. So it is $55,000 to $75,000 Australian dollar. Within US, it is roughly, I think it is 45 to 50 lakhs. That is what accountants are getting paid. Within Australia, it is about 35 to 40 lakhs. Within Ireland, it is more or less same. Within Canada also, it is about 35 to 40 lakhs. So this is the general standard pay for all of these countries to their accountants or chartered accountants. This is what they're getting paid. So I'm just showing this to help you understand what career opportunities are there. If you move to these countries on PR or maybe education, these are the kind of financial opportunities that you can expect. Next, a lot of people might have apprehension that with my kids, with my family, with because now I'm married, I don't want to move out. What opportunities can I explore from India? Like sitting at India, can I do something worthwhile? So again, as Hansraj sir was mentioning about the KPOs, which government is trying to facilitate, and in fact, the ICAI is pushing up and making a lot of efforts to introduce this concept and making it more prevalent. So you can even think about opening up your own knowledge process outsourcing. So basically, knowledge process outsourcing kya hoti hai? Aapke accounting practices mein bhi aajkal bahut popular ho chuka hai ki lot of accounting firms in Australia, US, UK, Canada, they usually do not hire accountants over there because obviously aapne dekha ki kitna pay karna padta hai. It is about 30-35 lakhs for a single accountant, and maybe if he's in US, it will be about 45-50 lakhs of salary you'll have to give to one accountant. Same kind of work these companies can outsource to some Indian KPOs. Indian companies ko outsource kar sakti hain. Wo Indian companies yahi kaam hourly basis pe bahut kam rate pe kar deti hain, right? We can become somebody who can start these KPOs, and we can charge on hourly basis, and we can do that entire work of those companies. So it sounds very lucrative, but again, it's not very easy. There is a step-by-step approach which you have to follow if you would like to establish your own KPO, which we'll be talking about in the subsequent slides. So KPO, to aap samajh gaye honge. IT mein ye cheez badi popular hai, right? Within information technology and software companies, you might have worked with a lot of software companies. Aap unka auditing bhi dekhte honge, unke foreign ke remittance bhi aapne dekhe honge. So within IT, it is very common to have an outsourcing unit where those foreign companies are giving their technology, software development work to Indian IT companies. Reason again being, it is very cheap over here to do those kind of work, right? Aapke liye bhi aaj Indore jaisi jagah pe jahan cost of living bahut low hai, jahan pe kisi article ko aapko utna pay nahi karna padta hai. For us, the accounting work, again, we are not spending that much to do those things, right? So it's very easy for us to pick up these outsourcing work, and we can do it at 1/10 of cost. Hum log 1/10 ya 1/15 of the cost pe kar sakte hain for the money that these companies are paying to their employees over there. So what exactly is a knowledge process outsourcing? It's like many companies based in US, UK, Australia, and Canada want to outsource their auditing, taxation, bookkeeping, and other accounting services to countries where it can be done cheaply. So India comes into the picture. And again, because we are English speaking country, these countries are very open to give us work because the mode of communication, and that is English, in which both the parties are comfortable. So it's easy to facilitate a business, right? They are also looking for reliable partners or associates who can keep the confidentiality of clients' data and can provide error-free services, which again, because apna jo ICAI hai, that is very strong on ethics, right? Strong code of conduct is being followed, because of which we usually follow a lot of compliance practices already that creates trust factors. And these companies outside, they are willing to give their confidentiality of data to us. But there are certain things which they'll be looking at. We'll talk about those things. So what is the first step in order to proceed if you would like to establish your own KPO? What is the first step you can take? So building credentials and trust, that is the first thing. Obviously, if you would like to pick up any work from these companies, you have to understand their auditing, taxing structure, what kind of taxation rules are there, what auditing practices are there. So you'll have to be well-versed with their accounting practices. So one of the things which you can do in order to build up that credentials and trust is to complete the CPA, right? So US has its own CPA, Canada has its own CPA, Australia has its own CPA certification. Good part being ICI has memorandum of understanding with all of these countries, because of which you will not have to study that much to clear your certification. Aapko kuch hours ka padke, I think it's about 40 hours, you have to study for your CPA in order to get the qualification of any of these countries, right? You can be recognized as their CPA, right? US CPA recognized ho sakte hain, or you can gain qualification of Canadian CPA or Australian CPA by clearing their CPA qualification and examination. The benefit it gives you is that you develop credentials and trust, first of all. You also get familiar with the taxation rules, laws, and auditing practices of these targeted countries, and especially with their softwares. Jo wahan pe bahut, jaise aapke yahan pe Tally bahut famous hai. So Hansraj sir was mentioning QuickBooks, Sage, Peachtree. So all of these are famous softwares and tools which are very prevalent in their accounting practices. So if you try to complete your CPA, you build up good trust. You also build up good network of professionals, because CPA body ko jab aap belong karte hain, to jis tarike ka aapko ICI ke through sessions mil rahe hain. Similarly, CPA as a body conducts a lot of these information and networking sessions, whereby you can have access to those companies, those people from where you would like to take up your work. जहां से आप अपना काम या आउटसोर्सिंग उठाना चाह रहे हैं, उस तरह की नेटवर्किंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज भी आपको CPA can provide you. You will have to know of accounting practices of targeted country, that is must, which I think CPA is going to cover. If you try to cover your CPA, this is one of the things that will cover within that. Next, let's talk about, if I'm done with the first step, what is the next step? So it is about starting small. We obviously cannot go to US directly and start pitching it to the companies and taking up work from there. Jab tak hame certainty nahi ho. To iske liye hum kya steps yahi se baithke chote chote le sakte hain to build up our own small KPO setup. So the first thing that you guys can do is that you can look for freelance opportunities from upworkfreelance.com. So Upwork is a website where a lot of these companies in US, Canada, Australia, they are putting up their accounting related outsourcing work, right? That we need somebody to take care of our bookkeeping for next 1 year, 6 months, right? So you as a KPO or you as a freelancer who has knowledge of those accounting practices or bookkeeping, you can pitch your hourly pay and then you can take up that work. So maybe initially the pay is small, right? Aapke first few assignments crack karna mushkil hote hain kyunki in websites pe bhi aapka profile develop hona padta hai. Upwork and freelance.com pe bhi when you go, you'll find that there are several accounting firms which have already established their reputation over there. They have good profile. So initially it would be hard to get the clients, right? But it is a similar practice. If you are doing your own practice in India, you must be knowing that initially it was hard, but then by a referral, you got a lot of people. Aapne ek company ka kaam uthaya, uska acche se karke dena aapne chalu kiya, that company or client referred you to other clients. And that's how you started building up your reputation and network. Similarly, first few assignments would be challenging, but if you constantly go and pitch on Upwork and freelance.com, start very small, take up some bookkeeping or very ordinary work, uska early pay pe karke, you try to deliver that work diligently, you'll get good ratings and points for that. The clients will put up good reviews. The best part being, if somebody is impressed with your work, they give it to you permanently. Aap logo ke practice mein sabse achhi cheez kya hai ki agar aapke paas koi client aa jata hai, so next few years tak, he'll stay with you only. Aisa nahi hai accounting mein kabhi bhi people do not change their accountants every year. Why? Because the accountant now has thorough understanding of your business, the way things are moving. So there's some kind of understanding which has already been developed, which would become very difficult if he has to approach to a new accountant. So within accounting services, people try to keep things for long term, which is something jo aapko yahan pe milega. Agar aapne Upwork pe koi ek client bhi uthaya, freelance.com pe ek client bhi uthaya, maybe he has given you work for 6 months, 3 months, or maybe it was a one-time assignment he has given to you, but that will obviously create a long-term relationship with that client, and that client can refer you to more clients, and that's how you can build up your profile and business over there. Plus, this also gives you good learning ground and opportunity to understand ki inke practices mein ye log karte kya hain. Aap directly koi bada client uthaen, uske saath galtiyon se seekhein, isse acha hai ki if I do it with a small client and I try to learn it from the mistakes I'm making, it's better I'll create a good reputation for myself so that I can pitch it to bigger clients also. Once you'll become confident by taking small assignments, aap usko bade paimane pe bhi le ja sakte hain baad mein. So this is one opportunity you can explore, freelance opportunities from Upwork and freelance.com. मैंने कुछ इसके स्क्रीनशॉट भी लिए हैं कि किस तरह के काम यहाँ पे अभी आते हैं, तो आप वहाँ से चालू कर सकते हैं अपनी प्रैक्टिसेस डेवलप करना. इनिशियली यू माइट फील कि ये बहुत छोटी चीज़ें हैं, बट ट्रस्ट मी ऑल दी बिग KPOs विच आर वर्किंग इन दिल्ली, गुड़गांव, नोएडा, हैदराबाद, जिनके पास अकाउंटिंग के लिए ही 200-300 एम्प्लॉयज हैं, दे ऑल स्टार्टेड विद अ वेरी स्मॉल स्केल. They all started with a single transaction, single assignment, but now they expanded to 100 employees, 200 employees. So they all started small. So aap aisa underestimate mat karna, aapki humble beginnings ho sakti hain, chote assignments ho sakte hain, but in future it's going to augment like anything. Ye badhega aapka. So these are few recommendations which I'm making, ki aap kahan se chalu kar sakte hain. So you can build up a good website and add security features and trust factors in that. Because obviously a foreign client is little hesitant in giving you work until and unless he don't see you. He doesn't see you as a very trustworthy partner. So aapko apni website pe apne bare mein batana chahiye, apne credentials wahan pe rakhne chahiye. So all of these things you should be mentioning over there. Right? So apna CP agar aapne kiya hai, to aap usko wahan pe dikhaiye. Why that firm should be choosing you. Put up those credentials over there so that people can trust you. रीचिंग आउट टू इंडियन CPAs, ये एक बहुत अच्छा तरीका है. अगर आपको लग रहा है कि यहाँ से बैठे काम उठाना मुश्किल है, विच ऑब्वियसली इज, यू कैन रीच आउट टू इंडियन CPAs हु ऑलरेडी हैव देयर ओल्ड प्रैक्टिस इन US, UK, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड कैनेडा. सो देयर आर लॉट ऑफ स्मॉल फर्म्स जहाँ पे इंडियन CPAs या तो एम्प्लॉयड हैं या दे देमसेल्व्स आर रनिंग दोज फर्म्स इन US, UK, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड कैनेडा. इंडियन CPAs को अप्रोच करना फिर भी ईजी है, बिकॉज यू बींग इंडियन, दे लुक यू विद दैट ट्रस्ट फैक्टर. राइट, क्योंकि आप यहाँ के CA हैं, तो ऑब्वियसली एक कॉमन कम्युनिटी ऑफ फ्रेटर्निटी आप लोगों के बीच में रहती है. इस कारण से इंडियन CPAs, दे टेंड टू ट्रस्ट यू इजली, उनसे काम निकलवाना इजी हो सकता है. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, समबडी हू इज रनिंग एज CPA, CPA हू इज रनिंग एज अकाउंटिंग फर्म इन UK, यू कैन पिच हिम दैट आई कैन टेक अप योर वर्क एंड आई कैन डू इट इन इंडिया एट सो एंड सो रेट. आई कैन चार्ज आर्ली रेट्स पे, मैं इतना इतना चार्ज कर सकता हूँ आपको. And from there, you can take up some small assignments and work, develop good trust, and you can take a lot of work from there. Referrals bhi aayenge, usse aapka kaam bhi badhega. To aap, ab CPAs ko aap kahan reach out kar sakte hain? So I think LinkedIn has become a very good platform, right? So if you are very active on LinkedIn, you can see what CPAs are active in different territories in US, UK, Australia. Try to connect them on LinkedIn and try to approach small firms that are ready to give you work. Small firms yani, कोई रेस्टोरेंट हो सकता है, कोई कैफे शॉप हो सकता है, कोई स्मॉल एंटरप्राइजेस हो सकता है. रिमेंबर, वी आर ट्राइंग टू स्टार्ट स्मॉल. ठीक है, तो पहले दिन से शायद हमें कोई बड़ी फर्म या कंपनी काम नहीं दे देगी, बट इफ यू ट्राई टू स्टार्ट स्मॉल, टारगेटिंग स्मॉल रेस्टोरेंट्स, कैफे शॉप्स थ्रू रेफरल्स, आपको काम मिलता जाएगा. एंड दीज स्मॉल रेस्टोरेंट्स अकेले आप न्यूयॉर्क में इमेजिन करेंगे, सो दे आर मोर देन, आई थिंक देर आर अबाउट 25,000 or 30,000 तो कैफेज हैं वहाँ पे. Restaurants, तो मैं गिन ही नहीं रहा हूँ, जस्ट दी कैफे शॉप्स आर 20,000-25,000. सो इमेजिन वॉट काइंड ऑफ वर्क अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर देयर. और वहाँ पे बुक कीपिंग इज प्रीटी एक्सपेंसिव. सो आप छोटे छोटे फर्म्स को भी अगर कैटर करें, तो यू कैन एक्चुअली टारगेट बिग चंक ऑफ बिजनेस. फ्यू ऑफ यू आर आस्किंग मी क्वेश्चंस, आई विल जस्ट कंप्लीट दी स्लाइड्स क्विकली एंड आई विल कम टू योर क्वेश्चन आंसर, जस्ट अ मोमेंट. So what things are required? As I said, that a good website, a trustworthy website that you have to create. Then second thing is to have Skype calling numbers for US, UK, because cold calling is also required. Once you have identified, okay, these are the restaurants or these are the clients that I want to target, you'll have to pitch it to those clients. Why to outsource their bookkeeping work to you guys, right? So you'll have to recruit staff that is proficient in speaking English with good accent and good in convincing the prospects of cold leads. Try to generate the cold leads. Investing in Google AdWords is must. If you would like to have opportunities within AdWords, pe aap dal sakte hain. Jaise if I try to see bookkeeping services in Indore, so you should be coming in the, at least in the top 10, top 21. So Google AdWords helps you to get into that page rank, getting into your first page ad space, although it's pretty expensive, but अगर आपको इनिशियली चालू करना है, तो आप यहाँ पे इन्वेस्ट करके देखिए. गूगल एडवर्ड से बहुत बिजनेस आते हैं, तो आप डिफरेंट टेरिटरीज के लिए अपने एडवर्ड्स चला सकते हैं. फॉर US, UK, US में भी दे आर डिफरेंट, 50 स्टेट्स आर देयर. सो फॉर एवरी स्टेट ऑल्सो यू कैन यूज गूगल एडवर्ड्स, फॉर टेक्सस, मे बी फॉर न्यूयॉर्क, फॉर न्यू जर्सी. So you can use Google AdWords to promote your services of accounting outsourcing over there. Putting up client case studies and testimonials about cost savings. This is something must, which a lot of us are not doing, I think. Whenever I've visited the websites of chartered accountants, this is something which is missing. You should actually be putting case studies and testimonials of your past clients. That again develops credibility, how you have helped them in cutting the cost, how you have helped them in saving their taxes. ये चीजें अगर आप डालना चालू करेंगे तो अगेन जो क्लाइंट्स बाहर के हैं वो जब आपकी वेबसाइट विजिट करेंगे दे विल सी दीज केस स्टडीज दे विल रीड इट एंड विद दिस टेस्टिमोनियल्स इट क्रिएट्स काइंड ऑफ गुड इंप्रेशन एंड क्रेडिबिलिटी फॉर योर सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड कंसल्टेंसी टू इंडियन कंपनीज हैविंग एस्टैब्लिशमेंट इन अब्रॉड सो लॉट ऑफ इनफैक्ट इंदौर की बहुत सारी आईटी कंपनीज है जिन्होंने अपनी प्रैक्टिसेस बाहर एस्टैब्लिश कर रखी हैं इनफैक्ट एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट आई नो समकित सर हैज हेल्प्ड लॉट ऑफ इंडियन इंदौर आईटी कंपनीज to establish their practices in US, to start their LLPs over there. So you can start that way also. You can provide consultancy to Indian companies who are establishing their practices abroad. So obviously they require somebody for the corporation of the company to check all the legal requirements. So again, in that way also you can start. You can assist any Indian IT companies to establish their practices in foreign, and that's how you can develop good network. Attending accounting trade fairs and conferences in targeted countries. So if you try to Google this particular thing, trade fairs bahut regular hote hain. Abhi COVID situation ke karan ye cheez hold pe aa gayi hai, but virtually bahut sare trade fairs ho rahe hain. So within accounting trade fairs, all the companies they come up, right? You'll get access to clients as someone who is owner of a KPO. You can participate in these trade fairs and conferences. And you'll be meeting the clients over there to whom you can pitch about your services and practices. So, अभी तो ये trade fairs virtually हो रहे हैं. आप Google करेंगे तो आपको ऐसे बहुत सारे online trade fairs मिल जाएंगे for US, UK, Australia, Canada. All these trade fairs obviously have a participating fee. जो आप pay करके you can get access to all the people who are coming in those trade fairs. This again creates good network of professionals through which you can have. यहाँ पे बहुत सारे वहाँ के chartered accountants आते हैं. वहाँ की बहुत सारी फर्म्स पार्टिसिपेट करती हैं जिनसे आप पिच कर सकते हैं उनका काम यहाँ पे उठाने के लिए आउटसोर्सिंग बोर्ड राइट सो दिस इज व्हाट अपवर्क में जिस तरह की अपॉर्चुनिटीज अभी मैंने देखी हैं दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट इज कमिंग सो दिस पर्टिकुलर पोस्ट वाज दिस वाज पोस्टेड 2 days अगो ऑन अपवर्क दिस वाज बुक कीपिंग फॉर हांगकांग कंपनी फॉर ईयर ऑफ 2019 प्लस सेरो सेटअप एंड मेंटेनेंस सो दीज गाइज आर लुकिंग फॉर अ बुक कीपर अकाउंटेंट टू हेल्प देम विद books for Hong Kong company for the year this is the kind of pay they are expecting to give right depending upon your qualification and what competency you have in order to take up the work they have a pay rate of $15 to $40 per hour right which again to start with is a good pay aap yahan se chalu kariye and this project length is for more than 6 months to agar aapko har week 20 hours ka bhi kaam mil raha hai which is about $800 a week if I try to do it monthly, it is $3,200 for me. And if I do it for 6 months, so that is again a good amount of money that I'm getting, right? So aap is tarah ki bahut sari postings wahan pe aati hain jinke liye aap pitch kar sakte hain. You can create your profile on Upwork and these websites, Elance, Freelance, Upwork. Yahan pe aate hain. Ye ek aur post hai bookkeeping pe. So again, they are looking for very entry-level services. Yahan pay bahut kam hai. So aap chahein to To start small, you can pitch for these kind of opportunities. आप यहाँ से उठा सकते हैं चीजें, right? So this is all from my side. This is what I wanted to convey to you. I'll be taking question and answers now. So Gaurav ji is asking, I had received assignment from Germany and has knowledge of German laws. Can I set up an office in Germany? Okay. So
these are the questions जो कि members की तरफ से आए हुए हैं, तो मैंने chat option में आपको
Okay. Okay, so somebody is asking that they have got assignment from Germany and knowledge of German laws. Can I set up an office in Germany? So every country is giving you freedom to establish your own office. Like in US, I'm pretty much clear about this. US and Canada, they both have this practice of you can establish your own LLP just by sitting in India. You don't have to even visit US in order to set up a company. So for German laws, I'm not sure, but if we try to search it more on Google, I think we can get this information about the German laws. Another question is being asked. I want to move Australia. What skill set Apart from technical knowledge is required to be successful, do you think that COVID pandemic has affected demand of Indian CS globally? If yes, whether positive? So this is a momentary situation. As far as we can see, COVID is not going to remain forever. So obviously all industries have seen the impact of COVID. Business is on slowdown, but recovery will also be good in most of the countries. What we can see, V-shaped recovery is taking place. So V-shaped recovery is ki jaise jaise quickly niche giri thi economy, utni quickly upar bhi aane wali hai. So ye momentary situation hai, but this will not remain forever. In fact, all of these countries, they are always looking for accountants. Yahan pe accountant professionals jitne hote hain, unki hamesha kami rehti hai. So whoever has asked the question, trust me, you'll always have opportunities if you go to any of these countries. Initially, there'll be some sort of struggle. आप डायरेक्टली ये नहीं सोच सकते कि जाते से आपको अपॉर्चुनिटी मिल जाएगी. अगेन यू विल हैव टू स्टार्ट स्मॉल, यू विल हैव टू अप्लाई फॉर अपॉर्चुनिटीज ओवर देयर, बट ग्रेजुअली ट्रस्ट मी यू विल गेट पेड लाइक एनीथिंग. अकाउंटेंट्स इन दीज प्लेसेस, अकाउंटेंट्स को बहुत अच्छा पैसा मिलता है इन सब जगहों पे. तो इवन इफ यू वुड लाइक टू मूव टू ऑस्ट्रेलिया, माय पर्सनल रिकमेंडेशन इज अप्लाई फॉर योर पीआर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, राइट? ट्राई टू गेट योर सीपीए एंड देन मूव टू ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड लुक फॉर अपॉर्चुनिटीज ओवर देयर. दैट कुड बी द बेस्ट वे टू गेट गुड करियर अपॉर्चुनिटीज ओवर देयर.
One question from Aditi.
Sorry, question from Aditi Jain.
I am a new mother. I want to start again with professional services, preferring work from home some months. How shall I start? So just Aditi, the things which I mentioned right now, that you started from Upwork and Freelance, Elance, these kind of websites where some bookkeeping or small kind of work is coming up. Ab wahan se chalu kariye. Slowly and gradually you'll develop a good profile for yourself, and then you can pick up bigger assignments and bigger pays, hourly pays. So you can start small. And the good part about these opportunities, the good part that I can see is that remotely you can take up these opportunities. You don't have to go to client's location, collect their files and data, physically present hona zaruri nahi hai. All these things can be done remotely. So you can start picking up these opportunities. Try to visit Upwork and these websites, create your profile over there. That's how you can start.
सर एक मेंबर का सवाल है कि व्हाट इज ट्रांसक्रिप्ट ऑफ सीए डिग्री फॉर यूएसए सीपीए कोर्स.
सो ट्रांसक्रिप्ट इज बेसिकली सर अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ योर ग्रेड्स एंड मार्कशीट व्हिच यू आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम योर चार्टर्ड बॉडी. सो यूजुअली क्या होता है यूनिवर्सिटी एडमिशन प्रोसेस में भी विद इन यूनिवर्सिटी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव डन योर बीकॉम फ्रॉम डीएवीवी यूनिवर्सिटी. So DAVV University would issue you transcripts. Transcripts will have same description of what subjects you have studied, what grades you have achieved in that. It is basically a replica of your mark sheet with a heading of transcripts over it. So why this document is required? Because you can physically send a copy of this to anybody. आपको US CPA को भेजना है, आप उसको physical ये copy भेज सकते हैं. आपको वहाँ की universities को भेजना है, तो आप उसको physical copy भेज सकते हैं. क्योंकि आप अपनी original जो आपकी degree या mark sheet है, आप उसको क्योंकि इट्स अ सिंगल कॉपी, यू कैन नॉट सेंड इट टू एनीबॉडी, राइट? सो इन प्लेस ऑफ दैट यू यूजुअली गेट ट्रांसक्रिप्ट्स ऑफ योर क्रेडेंशियल्स, ऑफ योर एजुकेशन क्रेडेंशियल्स, व्हिच यू कैन शेयर इट विद हूएवर इज आस्किंग फॉर इट.
ओके सर, वन मोर, प्लीज पुट सम मोर लाइट ऑन गूगल लीड वर्ड्स
एडवर्ड्स.
गूगल एडवर्ड्स, सो गूगल एडवर्ड्स इज बेसिकली कि जैसे मैं आज सर्च करना चाहता हूँ कि for example, I am looking for tax practitioners within Indore. So I'll try to search, I'm writing it on chat box, tax consultants in Indore. So whenever you type anything, Google will give you suggestions also, right? Some organic suggestions are there, some non-paid suggestions bhi hote hain, jo page apni organic ranking se upar aa gaye hain, kyunki unme tax consultants ki bahut sari cheeze likhi hoti hain unke page ke andar, and those pages have been visited by several users in past. That's why organically they are coming up. तो वो non-paid pages होते हैं. और कुछ paid pages होते हैं जहाँ पे आपने देखा होगा कि ad word लिखा होता है, ad लिखा होता है. ऐसा लिख देता है Google कि this is ad. So this is basically ad word which I am suggesting that for this you can pitch. अभी ad words usually सस्ते नहीं होते हैं depending upon location. ये ad words का जो cost है that can change. If you are targeting UK clients, so obviously वो one click per click का charge वहाँ पे मेरे ख्याल से इट कुड बी 5 to 10 pounds फॉर वन क्लिक, व्हिच इज प्रीटी एक्सपेंसिव.
सर इसी से रिलेटेड मेरा एक क्वेश्चन हंसराज सर के लिए है. सर क्या हम गूगल एड सीए कम्युनिटी को, सीए प्रोफेशनल्स को अलाउड है? क्या हम गूगल
एडवर्टाइजिंग इज वन ऑफ द प्रैक्टिसेस जो नहीं
एडवर्टाइजिंग देयर आर एडवर्टाइजिंग गाइडलाइंस ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट ऑफ इंडिया
यस सर
वन कैन नॉट गो बियॉन्ड and naturally very recently there are certain changes in our ethical standards also the code of conduct also in the current scenario we have to look at what is allowed what is not allowed push and pull there are two methods so you yourself cannot go for the advertising the others if any question comes in then you can reply with so there are certain standards to it
so sir
Definitely, if you are into the corporate structure, then things are little different.
Right. So I'm sorry, I'm not aware about this.
I am having a partnership firm in Indore. मैं Google Ad service use करना चाहता हूँ. तो इसके लिए क्या special permission लेना पड़ेगा मुझे या specifically ये allowed नहीं है?
नहीं ये allowed नहीं है तो नहीं है. मतलब it is not even the special permission is not been allowed.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Next question, Uncle.
Sir, one more question. That what are the short courses available on the emerging issues abroad for Indian chartered accountants from ICAI?
Answer, sir.
Basically, if we really look at with the change of the time, basically now the scenario is little different which used to be before. Like if we talk about the IFRS, it is equally applicable in India and so many countries across the globe. So we have a equivalent like Ind AS, maybe some carved out, to which you can add upon and you will be equal to the IFRS professionals. Same is with the, like if you want to work in the UAE or the Dubai, so you have a VAT. VAT here is, though it is, VAT is the another course which has been gone through the GST and the Indirect Tax Committee. So there are the, this FAFD courses are there. So these are the different courses which empowers you, which strengthen you to look beyond the boundaries, which gives you a strength of the applicability, which you can apply the minds there also.
Okay, sir. So one more question. As a practicing chartered accountant, in which countries do you foresee the demand for the accounting process outsourcing?
Yeah, basically there are four major countries, like US is number one. US prefers to get the things done from India. Then Canada is the another country where they prefers to get the things done from India. Australia is the another way. And naturally this UK is the another country which find out yes, Indian chartered accountants capable enough to serve them up. So these are the major countries, but there are certain smaller countries also where the opportunities for the Indian process, accounting process outsourcing are there.
पंकज जी दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर यू ये हंसराज जी के क्वेश्चन का एक्सटेंशन है सो फॉर यूएस कनाडा ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड यूके व्हिच कंट्री हैज ईज ऑफ लिविंग आई मीन इफ इफ
ईज ऑफ लिविंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ सिटीजनशिप
या सिटीजनशिप एंड कंसीडरिंग ओवरऑल फाइनेंशियली
स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग इफ यू टॉक अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दीस कंट्रीज हैव गुड स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग लाइक इफ यू आर गेटिंग पेड दैट मच द काइंड ऑफ सैलरीज आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट इफ यू आर गेटिंग पेड दैट मच देन यू कैन एंजॉय गुड स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग इट्स जस्ट दैट कनाडा एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया दीस टू कंट्रीज दे आर इजियर दे आर वेरी फ्लेक्सिबल व्हेन इट कम्स टू गिविंग यू सिटीजनशिप ऑल्दो पे इज नॉट एज गुड एज यूएस पे यूजुअली यूएस से कम रहता है इनका But if I talk about gaining citizenship and looking for a long-term status that if you would like to become a citizen of any country, then it's easy to get into Canada and Australia. In those countries, it's very easy. Bagi standard of living, trust me, is all same in all of these countries. You'll get all those amenities, good work-life balance, everything else is same. It's just the difference is within Canada and Australia, the pay is not as much as Australia and standard of living is same. सिटीजनशिप का एक बेनिफिट जरूर है कि इट्स इजी टू गेट सिटीजनशिप
ओके नेक्स्ट फॉर चुक सर सर डू यू थिंक दैट द मेंबर्स नीड टू लर्न द फॉरेन लैंग्वेज टू अंडरस्टैंड द असाइनमेंट इन अदर कंट्रीज
या बेसिकली यू सी लाइक दिस इज अ एडेड एडवांटेज कम्युनिकेशन इज ऑलवेज बीन द फर्स्ट स्टेज इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू कम्युनिकेट प्रॉपरली विद द फॉरेन पार्टी So then though accounting can be there in the English, whatsoever the software they have, but the communication has to be so strong. Like if we talk about within India itself, there are hundreds and hundreds of the languages which at a different part, Life, if you go to the Bihar, to the different languages. If one goes to the Punjab, different languages. Maharashtra, different languages. If you are a local guy, so you they feel confident. Same way, if you can share the communicate in their local languages, that gives a strength to them, a better connect. So it's a good to have the language, because internationally it's a few languages which are been there in a particular region. Like if we talk about the French. French is all across Latin America and the other part of the some of the countries. So those can be definitely good for the same way Germany, if we talk about same way Japanese language, where you can, you want to pitch in some basic things to be understood with.
Sir, is there any certification course or some diploma courses for such requirement?
Provided by ICI.
Yeah, provided ICI gives us some courses on the different languages, whatsoever, wherever our committee feel like, yes, this area we can grab into. So we have a certificate courses. We have a courses on the languages, which are on a nowadays on the portal also. Nowadays through the virtual mode also. Yeah, yeah.
Sir, if firm Indore based firm want to work with CPA firm outside India, so whether it is allowed or not to work with them, and in what manner we can do this in networking
on a assignment basis, like they it is a client and the clientee relationship service provider.
Can we do any networking or association with them?
Yeah, there is a networking guidelines are under the under finalization stage.
Okay,
but as on date, if there is a relationship between a client and the clientee, a service provider and the service recipient, they engage you, they get your services, and they it has been paid accordingly. So then there is no bar.
Okay. Pankaj sir, aapke liye ek sawal hai ki can we use B1 B2 visa to get some work from US?
So B1 B2, but then our company has to sponsor you for that. B1 B2 basically is a visitor visa, right? On visitor visa, if you go and you try to have interviews with the companies, first of all, none of the companies would be interested in taking you on B1 visa. B2 is a business-based visa on which you can go for short-term assignments, for a meeting, client meeting you can go. So again, on that, you're not allowed to have employment opportunities. So if you go on B1, B2 and you start applying to companies over there, first thing is we are breaking the law of that country. Second thing, the employers will not be entertaining us because of this. Ki B1, B2 pe aake aap kyun jobs ke liye apply kar rahe ho? Aap to tourist visa pe aaye ho ya business purpose ke liye aaye ho? So you are only allowed to do those things. Why to? Ab aapke paas koi aisa source hai who is ready to give you employment opportunity, then it's a different thing. But on B1, B2, we are not allowed to take up job opportunities, and employers, they usually refrain people from sponsoring on B1 and B2. Kyunki aapka jo work visa hota hai US ke liye, that is H1B. So B1 se H1B ka conversion bahut mushkil hota hai. F1, which is a student visa, us pe aapka H1B conversion bahut easily ho jata hai. So work visa aapko student visa ke baad bahut easily mil sakta hai. Direct as a tourist or a business prospect or client meeting ke basis pe aapko H1B work visa milna bahut mushkil hai.
Hansraj sir, aapke liye hai ek sawal. Studying KPO by CA firm and approaching customers outside in the name of CA firm is being allowed by institute or not?
Basically, approaching is not a dip. Basically, if you are targeting one individual client, so then there is no issue. But if it is like, it does not sounds to be an advertisement. It does not sounds to be an advertisement. Suppose you have targeted one client, you can definitely refer, give your profile there, and start talking to them, starts approaching them, then there is no issue. If you start giving like an advertisement in the TV there, or giving some kind of advertisement of that nature, which is not been allowed, so then it is not allowed.
Sir, ek aur sawal hai ki what do you think that COVID pandemic has affected demand of Indian CS globally? If yes, whether positively or negatively?
Basically, there are two segments. Like if we talk about the, as far as the engagement, like if we talk about the, and in the employment, naturally it has gone down because the economy all across is down. But if we talk about the services by the Indian chartered accountants to the overseas, it is growing. It has not impacted. Rather, it is on the growth path because people have started looking like on the economy side, this is better option. This is more economical. This is more as far as the cost saving for them, because employment is costlier than the going to the outsourcing mechanism.
Sir, एक प्रोग्राम आपका 6 अगस्त को एक वर्चुअल प्रोग्राम हुआ था वेबिनार जॉइंट वेंचर इन इंडिया एन इंटरेक्टिव सेशन फॉर फॉरेन इन्वेस्टर्स ऑन बिल्डिंग पार्टनरशिप इन द कंट्री. सर बहुत अच्छा प्रोग्राम था. इस टाइप के कुछ प्रोग्राम्स और हम चाहते हैं कि अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट मेट्रो सिटीज इंदौर ब्रांच और छोटी ब्रांच में भी ऐसे प्रोग्राम्स का इंफॉर्मेशन हमें पहले से मिलता रहे और ऐसे प्रोग्राम और हम हमारी रिक्वेस्ट है कि ऐसे प्रोग्राम और होते रहना चाहिए. सर
अभी मैं आपको बता दूं आपके पास हर प्रोग्राम की जो भी हमारी कमेटी कर रही है उसकी सब प्रोग्राम्स की इंफॉर्मेशन जाएगी.
Okay,
एक हमारे अभी प्रोग्राम हम वीक लॉन्ग प्रोग्राम विद द डिफरेंट कंट्रीज अक्रॉस द ग्लोब. एक जो ग्लोबल वीक जो है वो हमारी ये कमेटी जो है अभी प्रोग्राम इज अंडर द फाइनलाइजेशन स्टेज. एज द अप्रूवल कम्स विल बी स्टार्टिंग ए प्रोग्राम फॉर ए वीक लॉन्ग प्रोग्राम मे बी 5-6 days कवरिंग ऑल द कंट्रीज अक्रॉस वेयर वी फाइंड द अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर there where we find like these are the focus countries for the Indian perspective. Same way my other committee is the committee for member in an industry because the business and the profession has to go together. Mm-hmm. We have a program on the 20th of this month from 11 to 1 where the Hindustan Unilever chairman MD Mr. Sunil Mehta will be there and from Gujarat this Amul jo hamara ek प्रोडक्ट घर घर का है उसके जो एमडी हैं वो एंड वन जेंटलमैन एज ए मिस्टर गोपाल अग्रवाल हु हैपेंस टू बी अ नेशनल स्पीकर नेशनल स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द बीजेपी ही इज कमिंग देयर एज ए पार्टी एज ए स्पीकर फ्रॉम द कमेटी कॉल्ड कमेटी फॉर मेंबर इन इंडस्ट्री एंड बिजनेस. दैट प्रोग्राम डिटेल्स आई एम आल्सो शेयरिंग विद यू. यू कैन प्रमोट इन योर इंदौर सिटी आल्सो.
सर वन क्वेश्चन आपसे है कि कोई सक्सेस स्टोरी सर शेयर करना चाहेंगे. सक्सेस स्टोरीज आपके कमिटी से जो भी बंदे ने अगर प्रभी हैं कि बाहर किसी ने काम लेके कुछ ऐसा.
या अभी मैं आपको बता दूं क्योंकि अभी वेरी रिसेंटली जो है बहुत सारे लोगों ने जो है मतलब दो दे हैव स्टार्टेड एट द वेरी फर्स्ट स्टेज इटसेल्फ दे आर नॉट ग्रोन टू द स्टेज वेयर वी एक्सपेक्ट मे बी 2-3 years डाउन द लाइन. But the starting point is there. So many startups has been entered into this APO, and that is with the efforts of this committee only. By the efforts of this committee only, and there are certain APOs which have been really been looking forward this aspects. Like I know some friends from the Ludhiana, some from the Mohali in Punjab, some from the Chandigarh also, some from Delhi. Those who have started working on this APO concept, though definitely the parameters are the same, ki investments, the infrastructure, IT infrastructure, that has to be without first investing. That is not the case now, ki one table chair and you starts working as a professional chartered accountant. Now you have to complete infrastructure. If you want to serve globally, complete infrastructure, all like office atmosphere, all securities, all like cyber security arrangements, all IT related issues. So then you have to invest accordingly and give the ways. So many success stories are there.
Pankaj ji, the same question is to you, and without naming any CA students or CA members name, if you can. Sir, success stories of CA went outside, out of India, doing job there, and those who are working from India, outsourcing, if you want to share, sir.
So I have a friend in Nagpur. So again, I'm not naming him, but then he is running a very successful outsourcing firm where he has taken up this thing, the bookkeeping work of a lot of companies in US. Mm-hmm. So he again started with those small restaurants, mm-hmm. within New York and other places. He started taking bookkeeping work of them and developed a good network of people and trust. And with that, he has taken up like right now I think some 200 plus restaurants are associated with him. They are giving him bookkeeping work, and he has got some 100 plus employees set up right now as a KPO. And okay. Talking about students, students have gone for courses like MBA, Masters in Finance, and they have started working. Some students are working with Deloitte US. Some have started working with KPMG within Canada. So these are few things which I have seen in past, and because of which the whole presentation that I have made is based on their experiences only. I have taken those points from these students or the people who have done it before.
Sir, ek sawal Hansraj sir aapke liye hai. कि इज देयर एनी ऑनलाइन पोर्टल फॉर एड्रेसिंग कंसर्न ऑफ मेंबर्स रिलेटेड टू ग्लोबल सर्विसेज
या बेसिकली यू लुक लाइक यू मस्ट द एज फार एज द ग्लोबल एम्प्लॉयमेंट इज कंसर्न वी आर गोइंग फॉर ए पोर्टल विच विल बी लॉन्च्ड वेरी शॉर्टली दैट विल बी अ रियली अ ग्रेट गुड प्लेटफॉर्म विच विल बी ब्रिंगिंग आउट फॉर द young members, more particularly the beneficiary will be the young members only, though it will be for everyone. Those for the employment is concerned. Same way, this platform will have the advantage of if anyone wants to serve, getting the services from a Indian chartered accountants, they can also post them there. So then it will be circulated amongst the members, those who wants to interest and have the structured system of serving to the others. Basically, you see, like there are some responsibilities which lies in between. As far the employment is concerned, it will be a portal. Portal will be for the benefit of the job giver also and job recipient also. So those are on the way of the process, starting of the portal in the, maybe in a month time or will that will be there in the. It's at a testing stage. It's at final stage of the testing.
Sir, a part of this employment, if any chartered accountant facing some problem outside India. So what type of backup ICAI provide to our members?
Yeah, indeed, this ICAI has a committee called International Affairs Committee.
Okay.
External Affairs Ministry is in the sports of the ICAI. Wherever any members of our fraternity faces any challenges, we have a chapters. Wherever the chapters are there, local members are there to support them up, our Indian professional itself. And wherever the chapter is not there, external affairs ministry, we can approach them up at the ICA level. ICA has a good made a report with them, and definitely when you can say any details of any member, those who needs any support from the ICA for their any challenges he is facing.
Okay, sir. Is there any specific contact number or mail ID which you can share with our members?
Yeah, there is a secretariat of the International Affairs Committee, ia@icai.in. IA means International Affairs, mm-hmm. ia@icai.in.
Okay, thank you. Next question.
Sir, one more question. If any member is researching on subject relating to export and bring out publications on the subject, so is there any platform to promote
such type of initiative?
Yeah, matlab anyone wants to anyone research
is,
on it?
Yes, anyone is any member is research on subject relating to export. Okay. Is there any platform provided by ICAI for promoting that type of publications or something?
No, we have a research committee also, and we have a international like CS and WTO committee for export of CS services and WTO, and we can otherwise it can be through the mechanism of our editorial board and our journal also that can be published if it is a unique enough. If it is a cut and paste, then there is a process of the looking at it, reviewing it, then only it is allowed to be published. So if he wants a project as such to be carried away, to be taken care of, so then research committee can also give some benefit to them for the undertaking the research also.
Sir, one more question. Is there any manual available for members for knowing the what are the other educational opportunities available abroad, which are linked to chartered accountants?
There is a manual called Quick. Our committee, this one of our committee has published one manual where the benefit this professional opportunities. quick referencer for the professional opportunities if it is meant for the whether it is India or the overseas. As far as we, this committee is also coming out with a manual which gives the professional opportunities in a different country to country specific. I'll be sharing with you some PPT also, like today whatsoever I have deliberated with you, so I'll share the PPT. Few other PPT also within the state also, if you can want to develop anything in your suppose in your own state, so the state, the economy of the state, what is the best part of it, whatsoever one has to, that PPT can also be shared by me to you. We have developed some PPT related with the state in India, those who are been empowered, those who are contributing best in the economy of the India. Basically, if we talk about the India is 100, so then there are certain states like Maharashtra stood at number one, maybe 10-11% contribution in the GDP of the country. Some are 7-8%, some maybe 1-2%. So that PPT can be shared with each one of you. Okay, what is the and the whatsoever the economic factors are, like economy of the agriculture, economy of the services, economy of the manufacturing sectors, those can be shared with each one.
I think we have covered all the queries and questions raised by members, and still if any queries or questions is pending, kindly mail us at Indore branch mail ID. We will try to resolve that as soon as possible. At last, I would like to express my sincere thanks towards our both speaker, our Central Council member, and Pankaj Singh ji for accepting and for giving your precious time to Indore branch, and also thankful to all members presented and attended this conference. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, all my friends from the Indore branch, the leaders of the Indore branch, for inviting me here. I hope this will be a starting point. We'll be moving together with a greater relationship, greater strength from the ICI and the branches across. Thank you very much.
Hope sir, बहुत जल्दी हम आपके physical presence को भी इंदौर में
महसूस बहुत अच्छा लगेगा हमें तो. मेरी तो इच्छा यही है कि भाई इंदौर जो है एक ऐसी clean city, और जो छोटा मुंबई हम बात करते हैं कि भैया इंदौर इज small जो है मुंबई, lot of opportunities. तो मैं जो है देखता हूँ कि भाई इंदौर वाले यदि थोड़ा सा एक्टिव हो जाएं तो ये देश के लिए जो है बहुत कुछ कर सकते हैं, और उम्मीद रखता हूँ कि इस प्रोफेशन के लिए और इस इंटरनेशनली इस प्रोफेशन को लाने के लिए इंदौर विल बी गिविंग द बेस्ट. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
मेंबर्स आर आस्किंग फॉर प्रेजेंटेशन. डियर मेंबर्स, वी आर गोइंग टू अपलोड इट ऑन आवर वेबसाइट. बोथ द प्रेजेंटेशन विल बी अपलोडेड.
थैंक यू सो मच
ICI इंदौर, हर्ष सर एंड एवरीबॉडी. थैंक यू
पंकज सर फॉर गिविंग योर टाइम इन दिस